Although I don't know who's pitching after 1, 2, and 3 at this point. I mean, once you get through Darvish and Snell and Musgrove,
yes.
Yeah, I don't know who's after.
No. Listen, I don't want to get into this thing where we do what we did yesterday more than once a month. I don't like it. I think it's unhealthy. And the fact that we can't seem to, I don't know, find a guy who was a top prospect in our organization to get on the mound when you need him and the opportunities are open. I just don't really, I don't want the arms in the bullpen as to become taxed this early in the season, because they don't want Blake Snell going past 5 innings. They don't really want Weathers going past 5 innings. So now 2 times a rotation, you're going to have at least 4 relievers on the mound. So I don't want to do what we did yesterday. Throw somebody out there who can give you 6 innings, and we'll go from there. Find them. Hey, Preller, guess what? This is part of your job, too. Not just spending somebody's money, bringing in big-time guys. That's also going through the bargain bin and finding guys. Or going through your farm system and, I don't know, finding your top pitching prospect and putting him on the mound. If he hits a couple people, so what? Like, what?
What if he gives up 8 runs?
Then he ain't the guy. We already got one of those. We already got one. Chris Paddack. So at least I would know. At least the fan base would know. And at least the Padres organization would know. This kid isn't the guy. And that's okay.
Know.
Well, you don't know.
You said earlier. That this guy sucks and he has never pitched an inning for the Padres.
You know what? Listen, here's a great example, Alex. You know what? You know who Gore is? Gore is that girl who you date. She's bomb. She's a little crazy. She gets a little too drunk. She gets wild at the bar. You're never going to take this girl to meet your mother. Zero, none, nada. Ain't going to happen. Ain't going to happen. You know why? Because she will not be accepted. That's who Gore is. Gore is great. The idea of him is great. He ain't never coming home. He ain't never coming home. He ain't meeting nobody. You ain't never see this kid pitch. Not in a Padre uniform at this level. Not productively. I just don't believe it's going to happen.
That's a really weird analogy. It was a strange analogy. You know, she's hot, she's bomb, she's drunk, she's fun at the bar, but you'll never bring her home to mom. Whereas Mackenzie Gore is your top prospect. He's down on the farm trying to work it all out because you need him eventually. Actually, you could use him right now, but he's never going to come. He's never going to be invited to meet your mom, huh?
How about this analogy for you, Browner? How about Mackenzie Gore is like that randomly hot person that you match up with on Tinder.
I don't have
like,
that.
Damn, look at this. Like, she's so hot. She's a great prospect of what I could possibly get. But right now you're just DMing. You haven't even met yet. You don't know if you're getting catfished yet. You don't know what's in front of you because you've never met her yet. But she's real hot on Tinder. Her profile picture is really looking good. And you scroll through all her Instagrams, you're like, damn, this girl's hot. But you don't really know her yet. Because you never met her. I think that's better now.
Hey, bro, listen. I pick up all my groceries in person. I don't have nobody shop for me. I'm good. I pass on the Tinder and the plenty of fish, coffee meets bagel, all that. I'm good, bro. I get out and I do my own hunting.
Yeah.
What do you think, Scott? Whose analogy is better here?
I like yours much better, Alex. I like your analogy much better.
Get out of here. Thank you. The idea of Gore is far more important and better than the actual person. I thought Miles was better. Whatever.
Let me say this, though, about Mackenzie Gore. Here's the thing that interests me. Who declares the number one prospect in your organization? Is that an organizational thing, or is that like an outside observer, like Baseball America, whatever that
outside
means?
Outside observers.
Okay. All right. So you're Baseball America. You're this publication about baseball. Does it even still exist in hard copy? Probably like most magazines.
Well, probably not.
Yeah. But you're Baseball America, okay? And you're saying, look, here's the Padres organization. Here's what's, you know, in the farm system. And based on where this person was drafted, you know, where they played high school or college ball, how old they are, maybe minor league accomplishments, whatever the case may be, they come up with some equation that ultimately brands somebody the number one prospect, 2, 3, 4, 5, et cetera. And they rank these prospects. Because Mackenzie Gore has this label.
Sixth overall.
Yeah, he was the sixth overall pick. I'm trying to remember. He played college ball. Where did he play? Or was he out of high school? I thought he was a college player. But the point is this. He's considered their top prospect by an outside observer. And that outside observer is saying, based on where they were picked, based on where they played, based on, you know, arm strength or number of pitches, whatever, they've come up with Mackenzie Gore's the number one prospect. Well, if you're the number one prospect and you're not like fresh out of high school and you're not 18 years old, if you're the number one prospect in the system, and it's been like this for a couple of years, as I recall, at this stage of the game where you feel like you're a real playoff contender and you're battling for first place, granted it's early May, and you've got five starters in the rotation and two of the five, I should actually say three of the five, really, because I'm thinking about Paddack, Lamet, and I'll throw Weathers into that. Between the three of those guys, one of them's got COVID, or at least is on the COVID exempt list, and two of them are hurt. And what's the likelihood that Weathers and Lamet come back this year and both are long-term productive based on these injuries that they're dealing with? I don't know. Doesn't look good.
They said Weathers isn't a surgical situation. They said that was more like a
dead arm.
Yeah. Okay. So see him more long term.
Okay, good. Dead arm means rest the dead arm and bring it back to life. Okay. But Lamet, I don't know how you guys feel. I mean, I don't have a lot of confidence that Lamet is going to return based on him being out at the end of last year and then him trying to come back this year and pitching two innings and he's already hurt again.
Yeah, and then the fact that Tingler says, I think we're going to start him on Sunday, doesn't start him on Sunday, and then you have these open spots and it's not starting him in either spot. So yeah, you would think so, that something's fishy.
So then if the number one prospect in your system is a starting pitcher and you can't get this kid up to the major leagues, then again, A, something's not right, and B, why is he still the number one prospect? You see, to me, that's the other part of it. We all expect, hey, he's the number one prospect, bring him up, put him in. But I guess
the list comes out before spring training, and then you go from there. But I mean, is it that difficult to understand that the kid's just not ready yet, regardless of ranking? How often do you hear rankings?
What's ready?
Luis Campusano is a 37th top prospect in all of baseball. He came up here and he was garbage. So what do you want to take from that? CJ Abrams is the 8th ranked prospect in all of baseball right now. Are we calling for him to come up right now?
No. There's nowhere to play him.
Right. But what I'm saying is, Campusano wasn't ready. He was forced to come up here because of the Nola injury, and it was clear that he wasn't ready. So why can't we just accept that Gore's not ready? Why rush him up?
I guess
just because Weathers had success?
Well, I think in part it's because the need is there. You know, in other words, if Lamet were healthy and Weathers were completely healthy and you had a strong 5-man rotation and you felt really good about it, then you wouldn't have the need.
We're not there watching the guy struggle. If he's struggling at the training site, if he's struggling at El Paso, why bring him up to struggle here?
Well, no. I'm not saying bring him up to struggle here. I'm saying that Browner, unfortunately, might actually be right, which is he's not ready. That's fine. But the question of will he ever really be ready is certainly something that I think people are starting to question.